Dear brothers and sisters, welcome all of you to St. John's Cathedral to join us in the light service of Tenebrae. Tenebrae is a passage from light to darkness. 15 candles are lit and will be extinguished one by one, leaving only a single burning, representing the everlasting light of Christ. So let us prepare our heart and mind to walk with Christ through his passion and death. Please stand for the opening hymn. God is light, in whom there is no darkness at all. Jesus Christ is the light of the world. This is the judgment. Light has come into the world, but the people love darkness rather than light.
Jesus prays on the Mount of Olives. Jesus came out and went, as was his custom, to the Mount of Olives. And the disciples followed him. When he reached the place, he said to them, "Pray that you may not come into the time of trial." Then he withdrew from them about a stone's throw, knelt down, and prayed. "Father, if you are willing, remove this cup from me, yet not my will, but yours be done. Then an angel from heaven appeared to him and gave him strength. In his anguish, he prayed more earnestly, and his sweat became like great drops of blood falling down on the ground. When he got up from prayer, he came to the disciples and found them sleeping because of grief. And he said to them, "Why are you sleeping? Get up and pray that you may not come into the time of trial."
Rescue me from my enemies, O my God. Set me high above those that rise up against me. Save me from the evildoers and from murderous foes. Mighty stir of trouble against me, not for any fault or sin of mine, O Lord. For no offense they run and prepare themselves for
Jesus is arrested. While Jesus was still speaking, suddenly a crowd came, and the one called Judas, one of the 12, was leading them. He approached Jesus to kiss him. But Jesus said to him, "Judas, is it with a kiss that you are betraying the Son of Man?" When those who were around him saw what was coming, they asked, "Lord, should we strike with the sword?" Then one of them struck the slave of the high priest and cut off his right ear. But Jesus said, "No more of this." And he touched his ear and healed him. Then Jesus said to the chief priest, the officers of the temple police, and the elders who had come for him, "Have you come out with swords and clubs as if I were a bandit? When I was with you day after day in the temple, you did not lay hands on me. But this is your hour and the power of darkness."
I have become a reproach to all my enemies and even to my neighbors, an object of dread to my acquaintances. When they see me in the street, they flee from me. I am forgotten like one that is dead out of my mind. I have become like a broken vessel, for I have heard the whispering of the crowd, fear is on every side. They seem together against me and plot to take my life.
Peter disowns Jesus. Then they seize Jesus and led him away, bringing him into the high priest's house. But Peter was following at a distance. When they had kindled a fire in the middle of the courtyard and sat down together, Peter sat among them. Then a servant girl, seeing him in the firelight, stared at him and said, "This man also was with him." But he denied, saying, "Woman, I do not know him." A little later, someone else, on seeing him, said, "You also are one of them." But Peter said, "Man, I am not." Then, about an hour later, yet another kept insisting, "Surely this man also was with him, for he is a Galilean." But Peter said, "Man, I do not know what you are talking about." At that moment, while he was still speaking, the court cleared. The Lord turned and looked at Peter. Then Peter remembered the word of the Lord, how he had said to him, "Before the court closed today, you will deny me three times." And he went out and wept bitterly.
Jesus before Pilate and Herod. Now the men who were holding Jesus began to mock him and beat him. They also blindfolded him and kept asking him, "Prophesy, who is it that struck you?" They kept heaping many other insults on him. When they came, the assembly of the elders of the people, both chief priests and scribes, gathered together, and they brought him to their council. They said, "If you are the Messiah, tell us." He replied, "If I tell you, you will not believe, and if I question you, you will not answer. But from now on, the Son of Man will be seated at the right hand of the power of God." All of them asked, "Are you then the Son of God?" He said to them, "You say that I am." Then they said, "What further testimony do we need? We have heard it ourselves from his own lips." Then the assembly rose as a body and brought Jesus before Pilate. They began to accuse him, saying, "We found this man perverting our nation, forbidding us to pay taxes to the emperor, and saying that he himself is the Messiah, a king." Then Pilate asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" He answered, "You say so." Then Pilate said to the chief priests and the crowds, "I find no basis for an accusation against this man." But they were insistent and said, "He stirs up the people by teaching throughout all Judea, from Galilee, where he began, even to this place." When Pilate heard this, he asked whether the man was a Galilean. And when he learned that he was under Herod's jurisdiction, he sent him off to Herod, who was himself in Jerusalem at that time. When Herod saw Jesus, he was very glad, for he had been wanting to see him for a long time, because he had heard about him and was hoping to see him perform some sign. He questioned him at some length, but Jesus gave him no answer. The chief priests and the scribes stood by, vehemently accusing him. Even Herod with his soldiers treated him with contempt and mocked him. Then he put an elegant robe on him and sent him back to Pilate. That same day, Herod and Pilate became friends with each other. Before this, they had been enemies.
Do not cast me away in the time of old age. Forsake me not when my strength fails, for my enemies are talking against me. And those who lie in wait for my life take counsel together. They say God has forsaken him. Pursue him and take him. Because there is none to deliver him. O God, be not far from me. Come quickly to help me, O my God.
Jesus is sentenced. Pilate then called together the chief priest, the leaders, and the people, and said to them, "You brought me this man as one who was perverting the people. And here I have examined him in your presence, and have not found this man guilty of any of your charges against him. Neither has Herod, for he sent him back to us. Indeed, he has done nothing to deserve death. I will therefore have him flogged and release him." Then they all shouted out together, "Away with this fellow! Release Barabbas for us!" This was a man who had been put in prison for an insurrection that had taken place in the city and for murder. Pilate, wanting to release Jesus, addressed them again. But they kept shouting, "Crucify! Crucify him!" A third time he said to them, "Why, what evil has he done? I have found in him no ground for the sentence of death. I will therefore have him flogged and then release him." But they kept urgently demanding with loud shouts that he should be crucified, and their voices prevailed. So Pilate gave his verdict that their demand should be granted. He released the man they asked for, the one who had been put in prison for insurrection and murder, and he handed Jesus over as they wished.
The sorrows of my heart have increased. Oh, bring me out of my distress. Look upon my adversity and misery. And forgive me all my sin. Look upon my enemies, for they are many. And they bear a violent hatred against me. O keep my soul and deliver me. Let me not be put to shame, for I have put my trust in you. Let integrity and uprightness preserve me, for my hope has been in you. Deliver Israel, O God, out of all his troubles.
Jesus is crucified. As they led Jesus away, they seized a man, Simon of Cyrene, who was coming from the country, and they laid a cloth on him and made him carry it behind Jesus. A great number of the people followed him, and among them were women who were beating their breasts and wailing for him. But Jesus turned to them and said, "Daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me, but weep for yourselves and for your children. For the days are surely coming when they will say, 'Blessed are the barren and the wombs that never bore, and the breast that never nursed.' Then they will begin to say to the mountains, 'Fall on us,' and to the hills, 'Cover us.' For if they do this when the wood is green, what will happen when it is dry?" Two others also, who were criminals, were led away to be put to death with him. When they came to the place that is called the Skull, they crucified Jesus there with the criminals, one on his right and one on his left. Then Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." And they cast lots to divide his clothing. And the people stood by watching, but the leaders scoffed at him, saying, "He saved others. Let him save himself if he is the Messiah of God, his chosen one." The soldiers also mocked him, coming up and offering him sour wine, and saying, "If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself." There was also an inscription over him, "This is the King of the Jews." One of the criminals who were hanged there kept deriding him and saying, "Are you not the Messiah? Save yourself and us." But the other rebuked him, saying, "Do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? And we indeed have been condemned justly, for we are getting what we deserve for our deeds. But this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." He replied, "Truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise."
Be not far from me, for trouble is near at hand. And there is none to help. Mighty oxen come around me. Fat bulls of Bashan close me in on every side. They gave upon me with their mouths. As it were a ramping and a roaring lion, I am poured out like water, all my bones are out of joint. My heart has become like wax melting in the depths of my body. My mouth is dried up like a potsherd, my tongue cleaves to my gums. You have laid me in the dust of death, for the hounds are all about me, the pack of evildoers close in on me. They pierce my hands and my feet.
Jesus dies. It was now about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 PM. While the sun's light failed and the curtain of the temple was torn in two, then Jesus, crying with a loud voice, said, "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." Having said this, he breathed his last.
For my soul is full of troubles. My life draws me into the land of death. I am counted as one gone down to the pit. I am like one that has no strength, lost among the dead. Like the slain who lie in the grave, whom you remember no more.
Let us pray to the Father through his Son, who suffered on the cross for the world's redemption. Fill with your Spirit Christ's broken body, the Church. Give to Christian people everywhere a deep longing to take up the cross and to understand its mysterious glory. By the Saviour's cross and passion, Lord, save us and help us. Bless those who lead the Church's worship at this solemn time, in the preaching of the Word and the celebration of the sacraments. Draw your people close to you. By the Saviour's cross and passion, Lord, save us and help us. Strengthen those among us who are preparing for baptism, together with their teachers, sponsors, and families. Teach them what it means to die and rise with Christ, and prepare them to receive the breath of his Spirit. By the Saviour's cross and passion, Lord, save us and help us. Look in your mercy upon the world you loved so much that you sent your Son to suffer and to die. Strengthen those who work to share the reconciliation won at such a cost upon the cross. By the Saviour's cross and passion, Lord, save us and help us. Bring healing by the wounds of Christ to all who are weighed down by pain and injustice. Help the lonely and the betrayed, the suffering and the dying, to find strength in the companionship of Jesus and in his passion to know their salvation. By the Saviour's cross and passion, Lord, save us and help us. Welcome into paradise all who have left this world in your friendship. According to your promises, bring them with all your saints to share in all the benefits of Christ's death and resurrection. By the Saviour's cross and passion, Lord, save us and help us. Holy God, holy and strong, holy and immortal, have mercy on us.
Jesus is buried. When the centurion saw what had taken place, he praised God and said, "Certainly this man was innocent." And when all the crowds who had gathered there for this spectacle saw what had taken place, they returned home, beating their breasts. But all his acquaintances, including the women who had followed him from Galilee, stood at a distance, watching these things. Now there was a good and righteous man named Joseph, who, though a member of the council, had not agreed to their plan and action. He came from the Jewish town of Arimathea, and he was waiting expectantly for the kingdom of God. This man went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Then he took it down, wrapped it in a linen cloth, and laid it in a rock-hewn tomb, where no one had ever been laid. It was the day of preparation, and the Sabbath was beginning. The women who had come with him from Galilee followed, and they saw the tomb and how his body was laid. Then they returned and prepared spices and ointments.
I will bless the Lord who has given me counsel. And in the night watches he instructs my heart. I have set the Lord always before me. He is at my right hand, I shall not fall. Wherefore my heart is glad and my spirit rejoices. My flesh also shall rest secure, for you will not abandon my soul to death, nor suffer your faithful one to see the pit. You will show me the path of life, in your presence is the fullness of joy. And in your right hand are pleasures
for. Let us pray. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, for all the benefits you have given us, for the pains and insults you have suffered for us. Merciful Redeemer, friend and brother, may we know you more clearly, love you more dearly, and follow you more nearly all our days. Amen.